course, as we head into the final 36-hole stretch. This is Estes, second shot at one from 123.
Pretty nice start. That's what you have to do.
Chris DeMarco.
Just a little shot of 73 yards. Well played. Two wonderful shots to start the day.
Back over at the first, Estes to start his day with a three.
Probably just a little bit from right to left, slightly down the hill.
Birdie this hole on Friday, birdies it today.
Chris played a beautiful shot with a 57-degree wedge from 73 yards, and Curtis able to control the spin, which is what you worry about on this green, one of the smallest greens here at the Warren course.
Yeah, good point. All of these greens very small, very undulating, a lot of bumps and bruises in them.
Shot on three. See how far left he aims. He likes to cut the ball. That club goes outside on the backswing and outside on the downswing, and that was a perfect match right there. Kirk triplet. And he converts. Triplet steps it up into fourth place, nine under par. Chris DeMarco's third shot from the right side of the green here. He's going to have to go high on this thing to let it land on the green. Oh, he did it beautifully. Short side of himself. Cutters are always pretty good at hitting flop shots. Nice little left to right or up the hill and a good save. Even the flag in, kind of a nice bounce back from yesterday's bogey here on this. Definitely judged there. Beautiful stroke there from Steve. They were pure, he said.
Billy Andrade for birdie here at six. And a good bounce back.
Bob Estes' birdie putt here on five.
Slightly back uphill and moving ever so delicately to the left.
Really good putt there for Estes. He milks that putter when he goes over there. You can't have a strong grip when you're milking the putter. And boy, he's doing so many things well right now, and that's one of them.
Brad, that was for par for Retief Goosen, who is driving it wildly early in this third round. We'll have that. This for bogey. Here at the fourth, and Goosen is.
Billy Andrade's second shot here to the par four seventh after birdie on the sixth. So a moment ago. Oof. Beautiful touch there. We'll tie the birdie he made yesterday when he taps that and get him into.
Yeah, well played. Thank you.
Thanks. Yeah. Brock solid.
No problem for Steve Stricker. A 3-iron like everybody else, a 7-iron. Nice high little draw. center of the green. Stricker with another two. And that was a great view there. Steve Stricker, you know, when he moves his fingers. This is for eagle. Back of the green. Look at this whole location. Can it break that much? Can it break that much? It can. Hit it, Miguel. It would have been the first eagle of the day. You know, Estes birdie putt here on nine. It took a big hop, but that hopped right into the hole. Halfway there, it hit something, jumped up in the air, but he read that beautifully.
And just feed it a little from the right.
Oh, beautiful approach and iron. Steve Stricker hit his three, but as far as David Toms is driving it.
One breeze helping, a little downhill.
Two beautiful iron shots. Here at seven.
This for birdie here on the seventh. Trying to grind it out a little bit. So that one goes. Golf announcer Stricker for birdie, call it for us.
Good. You can't wait till it goes in. You can't wait till it goes in.
With the pause. You got to go with the pause.
You got to say it before he hits the ball.
You got to go with the pause. You have to create the energy.
We're on the par 5 17th. Boy, he's got such deft hands. Land that short up the false front. I don't know. He just has so much intention on every shot he hits, whether it's a drive off the tee, a little pitch like that. For birdie. Solid stroke there.
Back to 10, Bob Estes for birdie.
There you see coming up the slope, now down to the right. Wow.
I thought it was good.
We're playing with Bernard Langer. Langer gets one, or Andre gets one to twist in there. Only been nine birdies on this one.
The shaft.
Look at that.
Seven holes without a bogey will end here at the eighth.
And Estes for birdie on 11. Long putt. Oh, and he smashes it in the back of the hole. Back to 13. This is a moment ago. Langer's second shot. You see Billy Andrade's footprints there, and Langer negotiates the lip. There.
Just a huge mistake, Brad. It's 280 to that bunker. If you're going to lay up, lay up.
Not here.
And that one, Curtis, plugs. And now at 12 for bogey for Bob Estes, who is currently alone in second.
We have talked all week long. If you miss flag high, these greens are perched up. The farther you go back into the green, and it become very tough pit shots and bunker shots. And there you see what happens when you do miss flag high. Tough bunker.
Gee, we haven't watched Chief Goosen hit a shot in a while. Three over on the round, playing alongside David Toms. Big drive here. That's more like it, Retief.
118 yards to this front left hole location.
Another one-handed follow through, Michael. This is for birdie. Oh, he looks so solid over these mid-range putts like that between 5 and 10 feet. So tough hole location here. Oh, 3 from the edge. Yeah, tell Jerry Kelly that. Tell Retief Goosen that. Little draw.
Just once.
Kenny's leading the field in greens in regulation. We haven't seen him short side himself at all. Boy, he's got so much spin. He's in 2. Most players have their toe up. Oh, what a great roll for Stricker. That gets him to 18 under par. And Shane, that ties Fred. But both players catching the edge there.
Look at the grass under the ball, but not very inviting this one.
Yeah, it looked pretty stressful there. Bogey save. Now this is for his birdie to get to 6. Yeah, that was a good stroke. Second easiest hole on the golf course today. Unusual. Be easier than a up and down. See that graphic? 10-1 putts through 14. This will be 11. Retief Goosen had a birdie putt and missed his, so he made a par.
The shaft gives you a bit more stability.
Get it there.
I think he early walked because he didn't think he hit it hard enough, and then it was going to get there, and he thought it was going
to
turn. It
needs to go up, uphill all the way.
It was a great read by Stricker. Double breaker went up the hill to the right and then back to the left. A little tap in on making only 16 putts in the round today.
Speed is
now Estes bunker shot on 17. Boy, oh boy, did that look like it was going to go in. Tom's third shot here on 17. It's unbelievable, Brad.
And Brad, that is so incredible. He had to go low because there's tree trouble up. He hit a 7-iron and bounced it through the rough, and just incredible to get it anywhere on that hat.
Yeah, that was nice. Just plopped it out of there. Short little follow.
Just exactly what he had to do. Would have liked to have made it, but
round of 66 for Steve Stricker.
He saw the speed.
Two 64s to start the week for Jerry Kelly. He was so close at the Broadmoor a year ago to winning his first U.S. Senior Open.